Yeah.
All right, Aki Kareem, BBTV. I'm delighted to be joined by man of the moment, Maxi Hughes. Everyone's talking about your big win, mate, over John O'Carroll. Bit of an upset, but how's it been for you?
According to the on paper and on the bookmakers, it were an upset. But you know, us the lads in gym and the people who know me and my team, we didn't think, we knew what we were going to do. All I asked for is to get some credit from it. I've not heard it a lot, but I've heard it a bit that Jono has had an off night there. You know, almost just like trying to discredit me. It's like I feel like I said no. We were given 7 weeks' notice for a fight, which is plenty. We worked on stuff 7 weeks ago. We worked on it all the way through, and we executed on fight night, and it came off. So. It was me who dictated on fight night, and I came up trumps. I did what I needed to do. I don't want to hear no. I think Jono's come round and accepted it. Like, but it's other people. You know what it's like with people and their opinions.
Yeah, I think you make a fair point there. To be honest, I spoke to a lot of the boys beforehand from the VIP stable who I'm friends with. They were all backing you to win. And some of them got a good price on you to win as well. Yeah. So they made some money off you, mate. They owe you a drink.
Yeah, I think a lot of people have made some money on it. But again, it's like the bookies, whatever odds they give. I know Dan, who knows us from gym, he got 25 to 1. And my cousin, her husband, Carl, he got 25 to 1. That's like ridiculous. And it, yeah. You know... People who know in boxing know it wasn't that close. Like, we've done a lot of sparring with Jamie Moore at Jamie Moore's gym, and he backed me to win. The lads in his gym says I can win, so they knew, they'd seen what I can do, and they knew what I were able to do on fight night.
Yeah, I mean, so, and you're a fully fledged lightweight as well. I was when I saw the fight being made, I thought that's a very dangerous fight for John O'Carroll. You know. And you're a very experienced guy as well. It was a beautiful boxing match to watch, actually. Lovely compact boxing, close quarters.
Yeah.
It had everything, angles. Oh, it was great to watch. It was a good fight, really good fight as well.
Yeah. Yeah, and it was a good show, and I'm glad to be a part of it. MTK, all the boxing that's came back since COVID, they've all, because of the COVID, and they're not bringing easier opponents in, all the fights are top competitive fights. That card I boxed on Wednesday, everybody was so evenly matched, except for me on paper, according to bookies. But yeah, everybody were evenly matched, and a real good show overall. So MTK did a great job, and I think they've got other shows coming up there. And again, they're all really good, evenly matched fights and good shows.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, I'm sure you and John have got a lot of respect for each other after sharing a good distance fight like that. But, you know, there was still that second or two after the fight where you thought, well, Maxi probably done this, but is he going to get the decision? My heart must have been in your mouth, because you've been on the receiving end of some close ones in the past where the scoring hasn't reflected. Yeah.
After final bell went... I knew I'd done enough. I thought, you know, I knew deep down I'd won. I thought, I've won this fight, but are they going to give it me? And then, like, I don't know if I was just being paranoid, but, like, because where our changing rooms were, they were like a little hospital ward with the curtains. So we were right in the same room as ring, so we were able to watch all boxing. And the previous fights, which used the judges... I think I've just been paranoid, but the judges were quick to give the scores in. The MC got the verdict and were like, and got on with announcing the decision. And I was stood in corner with me and Noah Cans, and shook his corner's hands. And then I was stood in corner. Cutsman would just give me a wipe down, send the doctor. And I was like, why is it taking so long? Where's this decision now? Why is it taking so long? And I looked out, I saw three judges together, like passing the papers around and getting it ready. MC were there, and I thought, oh no, please no, just give me this. I know I've won it. Please give me it. And I was just anxious then until they said it, and then soon I knew that I'd won it, but it was just whether they were going to give me it, and you know, they give me it, and I was thrilled. I'm still up at Moon now, I'm buzzing.
Well, you know what? It's really interesting, Maxi, because I put a post out on British Boxers about the win, and I looked at our social media. The response for you was in the trade, was everybody was so happy for you in the trade. Why do you think it is that, you know, all boxing people inside the trade were so happy for you?
I've had quite a few fights. I've had a lot of competitive fights, and I've had a lot of fights which have been on Sky, on telly, and I'd say I'm a nice guy, friendly. Some say a bit too nice. I'm friend, you know, friendly with everybody. I just get on with it. I don't talk any trash. I just no nonsense. I get in the ring and I do my job. I'm 10 years as a pro this year, so I've been around a long time, and I've pushed a lot of top guys. I've had the three good fights with Martin Ward, Bowen, Liam Walsh, in the earlier days Scotty Cardle, when we were both up and coming. So I've been pushing the top guys and been really close. And you know, sometimes people are like, oh, maybe Maxi nicked that fight and he didn't get decision. So I think people have seen that and thought, you know what, this kid's kept trying. Like a few messages saying, fair play to you, Maxi, for sticking at it for as long as you have and just keep trying and trying. So I think that's why people are so pleased for me. Everybody who I've spoke to has said the things along that line, like, fair play to you for not quitting. You've just gritted your teeth and you keep getting on with it and you keep getting on. And I've got the results. And I remember I worked on a boxing show end of last year after I boxed Liam Walsh, and Josh Whale were on the show as well. And I think I'm a bit similar to Josh. Again, he'd been around for a long time. He'd pushed all the top guys all the way to the end. And again, he just stuck at it and he kept going and going. And he had a real some real success, did Josh, just by pure determination and sticking at it. And there's things like that. I love like that. You know, it is like cliche. It is the real Rocky story.
What's the secret, Maxine? What's your secret to, you know, keep going, keep pushing forward, not being put off by the setbacks? Like, how do you keep so down to earth and level and keep going forward?
I don't know. I've got a stable life at home, got a wife, a daughter, loving family, and so my home life is stable. I've got that. I've got a great team around me, great gym, all lads in gym. That's a great environment to be in. I think ultimately it comes down to me wanting to do it. If you ain't got that desire to be able to keep going and keep training hard, keep dieting, keep making the weight and keep going out running, if you ain't got that, then you're not going to get nowhere. These young up-and-comers will just turn you over and you'll get blasted out and nobody will want to, you know, you won't get the fight. So I think that comes into it as well. You know, I still want it and I've still got the belief that I could do it. I could beat these top guys. So I still think I can win a title. It's just a shame that the fight with Jonal wasn't for a title. But that now winning that should put me in good stead to fight for a title or another big fight, whatever it is. So, yeah, I think it just comes down to desire and determination to keep going.
You mentioned your gym mates as well. I know they're all made up for you. I spoke to Jimmy Harrington on the phone. He was absolutely made up for you. He says you popped down and you've seen all the lads, and you know, it's nice to for a fighter to sort of remember everyone that's around them and the team around them. Did you enjoy sort of catching up with all the lads?
Brilliant. Yeah, I love it. Yeah, the gym. I got a video on, I think it were either the weigh-in day or fight day. Josh got all, I think they were when they were training, they got all lads in gym together. They posted me a little video and sent me that were a nice little booster, all lads cheering me in, and I think they all went round to Josh's house to watch the fight. Josh put it on for him, and I think they were that met up. Just after the fight, we'd done the interviews and everything. Me and Sean had just got in the car, we'd set off to go straight home because we're only, you know, we're only half an hour from home. So we're like, yeah, let's get straight off home. And then Josh rung us and he says, are you at the hotel yet? And Sean says, no, we're going home. He says, oh, are you joking? He says, we're 10 minutes away from hotel. He says, well, that buzzing, after decision, we got straight in car and we drove straight down to hotel to meet you. So we took a detour and we went back to hotel and they were all waiting. And again and again, they give me a hero's reception, clapping outside hotel. So we had went into hotel and we had a celebratory drink and we had a laugh. And we spoke to all MTK a lot, the staff at MTK and the officials. We just had a laugh and, you know, just enjoying it. I saw Jono just before we left. A lot of respect for Jono. He's a real nice kid. And I can't believe in all the build-up, obviously we know what Carroll's like to get in his opponent's head and he talks that bit of trash, but he did nothing but show me any respect. I couldn't believe it. I'd check my phone and I'd be like, I'm ready here. I'm gonna have some messages or he's going to send me something here, but nothing all the way through and, you know, a lot of respect for Jono.
You deserve that celebration that night. I mean, you was with, you know, Papa Sean. Did you have some rum? Did you have a kebab? Did you celebrate in that sort of fashion?
No, we didn't. By the time we'd got done at hotel and drove home, it was getting late. I think Sean had his bottle of rum. That's just his standard thing to do, especially after a win like that. What did I do? I just got in. My missus and my daughter, they were in bed, but she left me two Dunkin' Donuts out, so I sat on my own in dark and I had two Dunkin' Donuts. That were a big celebration for me. I tell you what I did, obviously, I went to bed with a smile on my face, though.
Hey, that's why people love you, because after a big win, the biggest win of your career, you sat at home in the dark, Dunking your donuts into your brew. That's why people love you, mate.
Yeah.
But, you know, we need to get you more on social media, Maxi, because at the end of the day...
I know, yeah. A few people said that you need to get on social media. I am going to try now. I mean, since that fight on Wednesday, I've had an extra 500 followers and a load of messages. I'm still trying to get round to get them all. But every time I go on, log, because I mainly just use Instagram now. I've still got my Facebook and Twitter, but I'd hardly go on. I forgot my password for Twitter. But I go on Instagram and start trying to reply. And then the next time I go on, there's a load more messages and there's a load more comments. And I'm like, oh, I can't keep up with this. And that's only with 1,500 followers. But yeah, I am going to make a point now of, you know, especially trying to build on the momentum now and seems to have some more fans. So just keep the ball rolling and keep momentum going and keep in touch with everybody.
I think it's important, isn't it? Because really, you're coming off. I mean, it was a really good technical performance. I mean, you're counter-punching, the angles, the way you were slipping and sliding as well and making Jono miss. You know, that was as good as I've seen you, to be honest. So you really should be, you know, trying to push on and capitalise from this platform now, shouldn't you?
Yeah. Well, I've always, you know, I've had a career where I've been a pro 10 years, but I haven't been battered. I ain't had hard fights where I've been bust up and cut and having to take long times out. So I'll be able to go back to the gym next week and start light training and build up and keep improving. And I felt like I've just kept improving all the time. So that's another reason why I've stuck at it, because that's, with my sparring, I spar a lot of top kids in gyms, travel all, you know, all around. And so I know I'm improving. So now I think, right, well, we'll get back in gym next week and we'll keep improving and get ready for something else what comes. You know, fingers crossed, spoke to my manager, Steffi Bull, and I know him and Lee Eaton can work together with MTK. And this says that they should be able to, you know, to do some things for me and that. And get some good fights.
I certainly hope so, mate, because you really do deserve it. You're one of those fighters that's really put in the graft over the years. Everybody in the industry knows that as well. And it would be fitting for you to now get those you know, those shots that you deserve. What ideally would you like to see happen in the next sort of 6 months you know, in your own career then?
Yeah, whatever, if they can get me some sort of title fight, British, Commonwealth, European. Something on my bucket list is to fight abroad. That would be nice to do. I'm happy to travel anywhere. Just keep them big fights coming. Keep me interested. Keep me getting well up for fights. Like before the John O'Carroll fight, I just accepted to go to Russia to fight a 10-0 kid, a big knockout puncher, but it was totally unknown. And it were less than half the money that I got for John O'Carroll, and I had to travel, well, not Russia, but Belarus.
Yeah. LCS to show, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, the July show, yeah, that's right. Yeah. I was willing to go there because I didn't know what fights were going to come my way, especially with the COVID going off. Didn't know when I'll, you know, with my age getting on, I didn't know when I was going to fight again. So I accepted that, and then 2 days later, we got the offer from MTK to fight Carroll, and I jumped straight on it. So yes, there's never mind going to that Russia, like, but obviously Jono is fought for a world title. He's a blue tick. He's a blue tick on social media, big time. So I jumped at that, and that's what really got me well up for it. Those type of fights, them types of names that are gonna fire me up and, you know, get me juices flowing and get right into.
We'll have to start calling you the Blue Tick Hunter then, mate. That could be your new nickname instead of Maximus.
Get me that blue tick, yeah.
Yeah, but you know, at the end of the day, you know, have you got a message for Jono? Because you know, he now needs to look at coming back from a setback, and you know, he is a top lad, as you've mentioned, you know, and he is a very good boxer as well. So have you got something, you know, perhaps from your experience that you could perhaps pass on to him?
Well, you know, Jono himself's been around a long. He knows not to get his chin down over that. He said it himself. He knows how good I am, and I excelled on that night. So, Jono will be back. Again, I've got the utmost respect for Jono, and he's somebody who lives the life. He's took him and his family out to Marbella. They live in Spain. And I think he's opened a gym, so he'll be back. And again, he's got the desire. He knows what he wants. He didn't have to take that fight with me because, you know, the fight were originally matched at 9-7, which is, you know, in between super feather, which is his weight, and lightweight, which is my weight now. But it ended up I couldn't make 9-7. So we ended up getting the fight agreed to be made at 9-9, and that's not Jono's optimum fighting weight. Once he's back down at his weight, super featherweight, his optimum fighting weight, he'll be back. He doesn't need me to tell him what he knows what he needs to do. He'll be back.
Yeah, I'm sure he will. And for you, mate, what are the next few days like for you? Are you just chilling and winding with the family and just enjoying the well wishes?
Yeah, I've had. As you can see, I'm still in my golfing attire. I've been out for a get. I do enjoy, you know, in my downtime, I enjoy playing golf. I'm not the best at it, like, but I just love playing it. It's relaxing for me. So I've been out and played that today. Tomorrow we've got a belated second birthday party for my daughter. It was a birthday on the 6th of August, and we try and get a party every year for her. But selfishly, because of my fight, I says I'm not having the party at my house when there's going to be loads of party food. Everybody's going to be having fun. I'm going to have to be training. So selfishly, I says we'll do it after my fight, and we can double it up as a second birthday party and a celebration. So we've got that, and yeah, just rest of this weekend, some downtime with family, and then we'll slowly next week start, you know, steadily going back to the gym and start working. And not only that, I've got to go back to work Monday as well. I've had this week off for fight, but I've got some backlogged work that I need to catch up on building sites. So I'll be steadily
just leave
getting
some
back
Dunkin'
into
Donuts
gym,
for everyone else, mate.
Here's what story.
Just leave some Dunkin' Donuts for everyone else at the party.
Yeah.
Mate, it's been an absolute pleasure to catch up with you. You know, I'm absolutely made up for you as so many people, you know, in the North are. And we're looking forward to seeing, you know, where this can lead you now and this good golden sort of patch. We're hoping you really
we're just getting started. There might be another 10 years left in me. I might go till I'm 40.
Like a Let's fan. Do it, mate.
As I've been told, as Wayne Woods from Jimmy says, you see, he always says, he says, Maxie, he's like a fine wine. Just keeps getting better with age. So
that's it, mate. Is there anything you want to say, like, just, you know, to people that, you know, the pouring in of messages on social media and stuff?
Yeah,
for you and...
obviously, everybody who's in support of me, who's messaged me and commented and everything. I'm really appreciate all your support. It's brilliant. I'll try and get back to everybody individually. And just thanks for the support. It means a lot, and it's a bit uplifting. It is uplifting when you're getting all these messages of support. A lot of top boxers. Nate, who's messaged me, Jamie Moore's messaged me, Zelfa Barrett's messaged me, James Tennyson, the Benwell bomber from up north, Joey Laws. Who else is it? Robbie Davis. An old friend of mine, Gary Lockett, used to train me. I saw him, Gary, on night. But, a lot of messages like that, off, especially off the people in boxing who's proven their words, especially, do mean a lot. And again, they're really uplifting. And obviously, we've got our man, Josh, in Jim. He's been a big support for me, to be honest, Josh. And he really wanted me to win. So... just his words of encouragement in gym, his advice in gym. We've been out running together. I will go into his house and we're going on Josh's running route. Josh being pace setter, pushing me. So I've got a lot I owe to Josh for this camp as well. And just and generally all my team as well. I always forget because I'm with him every day. I forget that. You know, forget to thank them all, lads in gym, Sean, trainer, Jimmy, Nick, everybody who's all had their input. They know who they are. They make it all possible.
Well, mate, I'm absolutely made up for you, and thanks for you know, getting on this with me today.
No problem.
And you know, we'll catch up again soon. And nice one, Danny, and enjoy the rest of the evening.
Yeah, thank you, mate. You too. Have a good one.
Yeah, take care, mate. See you later.
Ciao, mate.
Bye-bye. Bye.